Hello, this is the first video that I'm actually talking in, and what I'm going to be doing today. I've recently, moved. This is a new room. You know, you have to clean out everything, and in my attic, I found a book. And I guess it doesn't belong to any of my parents, but somehow it got up there. So, here's the book. How to Break Your Addiction to a Person by Howard M. Halpern. And he has a PhD. And, When and Why Love Doesn't Work. When love doesn't work, when you don't know whether to continue a relationship or a marriage, when you know you should let go and don't, when you ask yourself what makes you stay, when you think your hopes might be unrealistic, when you doubt if your married lover really will leave wife/husband, when you believe you can't live without that person, and when you think you will never find somebody else again, this book provides the support you need. Basically, I'm going to read this because I think it has to do with me. The introduction. Maybe I'll just read the introduction. That seems pretty long. I'm not much of a reader, but not much of a musician. Introduction. It can be very hard to end a love relationship even when you know it is bad for you. When I refer to a relationship that is bad for you, I am not referring to a relationship that is going through the difficult periods of discord and disenchantment that are an in... Ow. Okay. Talking about relationships that are dead ends. Man. The introduction kind of sucks. Prisoner of love? Maybe the Surgeon General hasn't determined it yet, but staying in a bad relationship may be dangerous to your health. It can shake your self-esteem and destroy your self-confidence as surely as smoking can damage your lungs. When people say that their relationship with their partner, a lover or spouse, is killing them, it may be true. The tensions and chemical changes caused by stress... I'm sorry, I shouldn't be laughing. ...can throw any of your organ systems out of kilter, can drain your energy, and lower your resistance to all manner of unfriendly bugs. And often, it can drive one to the overuse of unhealthy escapes, such as alcohol, amphetamines, neurotics, tranquilizers, reckless pursuits, and suicidal acts. But even if there were no threat to your health, staying too long in a relationship that is deadening or deadly can cloud your life with frustration, I have that, anger, okay, emptiness, and despair. Not to be emo, but I have those. You may have tried to improve it, to breathe life back into it, but you have found your efforts have been futile. This is a serious book to use the word futile. You are certainly not alone. Many basically rational and practical people find that they are unable to leave a relationship even though they can see that it is bad for them. Their best judgment and their self-respect tell them to end it, but often, to their dismay, they hang on. They speak and act as if something were holding them back, as if their relationship was a prison and they were locked in. Friends and psychotherapists may have pointed out to them that in reality their prison door is wide open and all they need to do is step outside, and yet, as desperately unhappy as they are, they hold back. Some of them approach the threshold, then hesitate. Some may make brief sallies outside, but quickly retreat to the safety of prison in relief and despair. Something in them wants out. Something in them knows that they were not meant to live this way. Yet people in droves choose to remain in their prisons, making no effort to change them, except perhaps to hang pretty curtains over the bars and paint the walls in... Wow, this is very, very metaphorical. They may end up dying in a corner of their cell without having really been alive for years. Every day I listen to the struggles of men and women who feel imprisoned and unsatisfying in unsatisfying relationships. How long has it been? A little over 5 minutes? I guess this is a story or something. No, these are different people's stories. Alice like to say that I'm slowly growing crazy with Bert. He's so cut off from his feelings and so unresponsive to me that I feel I'm with a robot. Then she goes on with some more stuff that we don't care about. Okay. Being depressed is very selfish. Keep that in mind. Someone's really cruel to somebody. They all think that they love the other person. Alice, for example. I know he really loves me beneath his coldness. Why else would he not want to break up? Alice. Poor girl, you need to read this book. Let's skip to something. Sounds dumb. You are my security blanket. Eileen told me since Peter and I broke up, I get these horrible anxiety attacks. Sometimes I wake up terrified, at other times the fear hits me suddenly. Like when I leap. I'm sorry, I can't continue because one of my friends keeps talking to me and she's freaking out. Sam, you there? She's pretty much typed a book to herself. Oh, this is lovely. I'm gonna continue this though, because I have nothing better to do. So I'll talk to you guys later. Here's the book. I'll end it with this. There you go.